In this video, I'm going to be going over how Juice WRLD recorded Blood on My Jeans. I think that's the name of the song. They took Gunna off of it. I broke down Gunna vocal chain and how he recorded before, link in the description. But this is for the Juice WRLD people that want to see Juice chain and how he recorded. This is one of the Max Lord sessions, one of the mixing ones. So as we see, that's a UAD plug. I ain't touched nothing here. This was like V2 or some on the run. So like that's the name of the song. But it's like Blood on My Jeans. So just go through here. As we see, we got the stems here. So if you want to get your music to sound like Juice WRLD and how it was, I would suggest you get your songs mixed with the track outs, because Juice WRLD got his songs mixed with the track stems. Little baby, if you see this, man, don't copyright me, bro. I'm just educating people. So this is like a reaction, right? Yeah, so there's a lot of stuff going on here. So I'm curious to see. I don't know how they did the tune, but let's see. Okay, so this is his aux right here. So I know that's the aux. The record chain or the recording track that he recorded with. This is the EQ. So you can copy this to whatever you want. So if you want to record with the same settings, this is the compression, 5.2 gain, negative 24 threshold. The release is 178.2, 301, E6, attack 3.8. That's there. And then for Auto-Tune Pro, yeah, that's what we're looking at here. Retune speed of 9, humanize of 22, and it was in soprano. So yeah, and we got bus A. So I think those are like the reverbs and stuff that's probably way down here at the bottom. Bro, it's a lot of stuff going on down here at the bottom. Oh snap, there's something in my eye. This was the reverb used, was this one. So I don't have it. I can start the demo, but that's the reverb that was used. This is the delay that was used. My 3 delay here. The compressor right here. It just say vocal. Like, I'm pretty sure that's a stock one. Like, right there, it just say vocal. So use that. Long, same thing. Delay, it's just different delays. And that's the doubler down there. But let's get to the vocals. Okay. So let's see. Baby, I've been on the run, but I will never run from your love. Feel on my dick, there's a gun. Not right there, just a little above. I that's interesting, because I don't think I ever heard this song. Baby. He doing okay, there we go. I will never run from your love. Feel on my dick, there's a gun. Not right there, just a little above. I value my relationship is forever, but I've been cheating on the drugs. Broke up codeine in a new plug. Hit up hot rod pints, I need two of them. Flip his goddamn in my lungs. Green. Okay, so the vocals here, and then we got punches down here. And okay, so the libs are done with two different takes, and they're both paying the negative 76 LA3A here. That's creative, because they didn't duplicate them. Yeah, they didn't. Those are two different takes. That's cool. So let's look at it. Baby, I've been on the run, but I will never run from your love. Feel on my dick, there's a gun. Not right there, just a little above. Alright, so this melody here, this whole little intro part is cool. This rhymes with this. This goes with this. You can hear the emotion in his voice here. But he switches up the tone of voice here, and it gets a little bit more emotional, a little bit more up with it. And that goes back to something that I always try to tell artists. It's like, you want to play with the tempo, right? You want to like and play with the emotion and have the listener take them on a journey, on a little roller coaster ride, right? You don't want to stay monotone the whole time. Baby, I've been on the run, but I will never run from your love. Feel on my dick, there's a gun. Not right there, just a little above. I value my relationship is forever, but I've been cheating on the drugs. Yeah. Broke up codeine in a new plug. Hit up hot rod pints, I need two of them. Flip his goddamn in my lungs. Green. Chopper on me, I don't talk. Alright, so one thing that I've learned from breaking down Juice WRLD sessions is the fact that the emotional aspect of the music, right? You hear it in his voice, it connects. And then the melodies are so addictive, but they're so simple. But at the same time, it's like, it's how he's saying it, right? Because the pause is right here, right? It's just... Alright, so here go the hook. You gotta bear with me. I haven't heard this song, so this is my first time hearing this song and trying to like see what's going on with it. Close range, so I got blood on my jeans. Saints World Cup, ain't no red in my lane. Bank rolled up, I've been swimming in green. Still a blue face king. Benjamin Franklin come down. Okay, I like how he drug out this part right here. It added on to that effect or the emotional aspect that I'm telling you about. Like the beat, he's matching the energy of the beat. Saints World Cup, ain't no red in my lane. Bank rolled up, I've been swimming in green. That's hard. Hey, so like you see that one little punch right there, it gave you that contrast that you needed right there. Yeah. You see the ad-libs, two different sets of ad-libs, two different takes of ad-libs. It just adds to it. It makes shit different, right? And you pay attention to the punches. The punches are very clean. So take your time when you're punching in. Don't really do too much. Like, he didn't really do too much on the punches. Like, those punches are very clean. And let's see the, like, how the levels he came in recording on the vocals. So let's do analyze. Okay, so Juice came in around like negative 11.1 right there on the peak right there. If we did RMS levels, that's what it would be on RMS levels right there. But peak right there, it's 11, like negative 11.1. So. Yeah, that's hard. They get the chance, they'll end up murdering me. That shit got me. It's gonna take you to believe. I ain't gonna know. Get you a ticket. Walk through the night with my gun like a creep. My shirt made some more on my shoes, double C. I don't know what it's gonna take you to believe. I ain't going nowhere. I ain't gonna leave. Hey, hey. That part, that hard. Alright, so the voice going up higher. It's progressing the song. Now you're feeling like you're on a different part of it to where it's not the same as what you were just listening to before. So keep that in mind. And then, okay, so we go from these higher pitched vocal. So hold up. So like we go from these higher pitched recordings to a lower tone to give it a little bit more movement, a little bit more contrast, and a little bit more emotional value to it. And then we have a dub right here on this part right here, which adds or draws attention, adds emphasis to this part or emotion to it, whatever you want to say. I don't know which one is the like, this is the thing. So this probably got to be the hook. See what I'm saying? So this is the hook. This is verse. Like, yeah. And then I think they put Gunna part and they took it away. So, okay. Okay, that made more sense now. Okay. So, bear with me, Juice WRLD fans, man. Don't cancel me, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but this is like it's simple. Like, that's alright. And this is Juice's. I don't have the Q2 plugin. So, like, I'm sorry. But, there we go. Same EQ from the record. Tube leveling amplifier. I don't have this plugin, but you see it right here. It's a UAD plugin. C4 has the pensado vocal preset right here. You see that? The exciter right here. That's the settings on that. And it says default. You just copy that and screenshot it and be good to go. And then we have right here, this is the de-esser. All right, lead vox. This is a common one that a lot of people use. So you put this on and it'll be good for you. All right, so 1176, the purple one. That's what it looks like. All right, and then right here we have the stereo imager on his vocals right here. And that's basically it. Like, it's the same stuff as we go up, but the ad libs. So the ad libs you want to look at is the same EQ. All right, we have R comp right here. C4, same thing, passato vocal. All right, de-esser. Lead vox again on SSLE channel. The 1176 right here. R verb right here. And then we got stereo imager here. So that's basically it. Like, that's it. Besides, we got the beat right here and we got the stems of the beat up here. That's just the reality of the situation. Juice WRLD lives is back here, and then the verse is here. Now that I understand the song and kind of see how the song going, I'm seeing what it's like. So again with the verse. I like that part right there. Cause this definitely made the verse stand out a little bit better right here towards the ending, because he, like, it built it up to something, like, right? Cause we started off with a vibe and then it got a little bit higher. Yeah, this is definitely a good song. I fuck with the vibe of it. It was recorded very good. The punches are simple. Like, look at this punch right here. See, a lot of people be scared to start when it's still going, but that you gotta do it to make the transition better. But like, you see how the takes are, like, everything is clean, it's organized with that. Only difference is with this is, like, it's too many unused tracks in here. So what I would do, or would have done afterwards, would be to, like, go through and get rid of a lot of these tracks. Like, it's a lot of tracks in here. Like, it's a lot of tracks. But mainly the Juice, like, vocals are here. Everything's here. The ad-libs are way down here. But each engineer arranges things differently. But if you take anything away from this video, the things that you need to take away from the video is you need to record with emotion. You need to make sure your punches are clean. You need to be fitting the vibe of the song. The delivery needs to be on point. You need to be taking your listener on a journey. Right? So if you want to record music like Juice WRLD, it's simple. You just have to record with the emotion. You can't fake the emotion that you don't have. And when if you want to get a mix like Juice WRLD, understand Juice WRLD songs are not mixed to two tracks. Juice WRLD songs are mixed to trackouts, right? You see the stems here, right? The vocals will sit in the mix a lot better if you have the stems. This right here, I don't have all the plugins active, and this is not showing what it's supposed to sound like mixed and mastered and all that. I'm just breaking down the session, going over what it sounds like, how he recorded it.